श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ।
श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ।
गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ।
शुक्लाम्बरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजम् प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये अगजाननपद्मार्कं गजाननमहर्निशम्
अनेकदन्तं भक्तानां एकदन्तमुपास्महे ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवम्
निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम्
आधार्यं सर्वविद्यानां
हयग्रीवमुपास्महे
सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे
सर्वशक्तिसमन्विते
भयेभ्यः त्राहिनो देवी
दुर्गे देवी नमोऽस्तुते
सर्वचैतन्यरूपाम्
ताम् आद्याम् शक्तिम् च धीमहि
धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्।
So now we make a prarthana of Mahalakshmi, who is the Swarupam of this Dvitiya Charitam. In Mahishasura Mardini, the recording starts here.
చేశాను అంకుల్ నా అవుతుంది రికార్డ్ అవుతుంది
ఓకే సో దిస్ మహిషాసుర మర్దిని ధ్యాన శ్లోకం ఈజ్ మహాలక్ష్మి అండ్ వి ఆర్ రిసైటింగ్ ఇట్ ఓం అక్షస్ర పరశుం గదేషు కులిశం పద్మం ధనుష్కుండికాం దండం శక్తిమసిం చ చర్మజలజం ఘంటాం సురాభాజనం शूलं पाशसुदर्शने च दधतीं हस्तैः प्रसन्नाननां सेवे सैरिभमर्दिनीमिह महालक्ष्मीं सरोजस्थितां। यु ऑब्जर्व महालक्ष्मी सीटेड अपॉन द लोटस सीट, शी हैज इन हर हैंड्स सो मेनी वेपन्स एंड अस्त्रशस्त्रास including the Akshamala and many other more things. And to look at her, she is highly pleasant. Prasannananam. Her ananam, her face is so calm, quiet, inspiring. Therefore, she is prasannananam. And that kind of prasannanana Mahalakshmi, we are going to know more, note about her. And she is only the Durga Parameswari because she, the Rakshasa is there. Rakshasa Sainya is there. To destroy them, she has to have a universal, all-powerful form. So, the other day, we have covered up to the 50 slokas where the yuddha between the Rakshasa Sainyam and Durga Parameswari started, and the Rakshasas, it is Mahishasura, along with a large army and also Gajasainyam, Vajasainyam, and their number is thousands and thousands of them, and 50,000 people, they, all of them came to attack and fight with Durga Parameswari, along with also number of chariots, Athasainyam and Nagasainyam, that is Gajasainyam, and just like that, they all came and they wanted, they are fighting. Devyasaha Mahasuraha Yuyudhu Sayyuge. In 46th Sloka, it has been told that they have started fighting or battling with Mahadevi with such a large, enormous, powerful army. They go to koti, koti number, that is crores and crores of Rakshasas have come forth. And so there was a big, and Khadgai, but even Durga Parameswari also started replying and fighting back along with whatever thing that they have got. For example, Khadgaihi, Parasupattisaihi, and all Shakti Vastraihi, and like that, the Rakshasas picked up different kinds of weapons and employed upon Devi. But Devi was able to, in 49th sloka, we have noted that Devi was able to meet up all of them and also try to attack them who are trying to kill her. There is nothing more than that, but just to kill her. That is prachakramuhu tam hantum. All these asuras, they are trying their best to destroy and kill Devi Durga in the battle. But Durga Parameswari, with all her shaktis, she also is equally or more capable to be able to whip up all those shastras and shastras. And that too, there was not any kind of effort in trying to quell down or remove all those astras. So that's why in 50th stanza we have noted it was all a small sport for her, though the Rakshasas came with all seriousness, with a number of weapons and also a large army. But Leelaya Pratichheda Nija Shastra Astra Varshini. Ammavaru, she just poured down or rained. She rained the number of her own arrows, her own weapons, her own missiles. And while she was fighting with them, she had no iota of tiresomeness. The 50th stanza, Anayasa, that is, Ayasa is not there. So Leela and Anayasa, these are the two assets for Devi Durga when she was fighting with such a huge army of Rakshasas. Likewise in Ramayana, Yudhakanda, I mean Sundarakanda, before that Aranyakanda, elsewhere, you get a clue that Rama was able to fight without any much tiresomeness or fatigue thousands of Rakshasas. That is what, 14,000 Karadushanas, he was able to singly manage to kill all of them. So that is, Rama and Durga, both are the same. So Rama is male Purusha Vigraham and Durga Parameswari is Sri Vigraham. But whatever it is, so far as the Shakti or power is concerned, both are exclusively powerful and skilled and great. And they have not got any kind of ayasa or tiresomeness or fatigue. And whatever war they warred, all that was done very, very, very easy and freely, not with any extra effort. And now we have got to do with the 51 sloka, where the war continues. Actually, this is the only place where you have got a full description of the war or the kind of war that has taken place between the Sri Devata and the number of Rakshasas. So in Sri Vijayopasana, the warring capacity and victory therefore thereafter are also very much important. And always Durga Parameswari is Jaya Durga. The Jaya Shabda is always added to her. Therefore, she is always a victorious lady. That's why you see, I think somebody, that Rajaveshni Garu has protected, given us one Durga Parameswari taking her form in the Chandi Homam performed in the Basara Saraswati temple. Did you visit Saraswati temple in Basara, Rita Garu?
Where?
In Hyderabad.
I haven't been to Hyderabad.
You have missing so many things.
I know, I haven't been to Hyderabad. I think last time
Your voice is low, huh?
Oh, wait. I said last time that I went only to...
Yeah, I know your places of visit, but keep them in your calendar. Don't go only
for... Rameshwaram, Guruvayur, and Ankola, my Kuldevata. And you know what? I have been to Nasik to the Shiva. You know, there's a Shiva Lingam there in Nasik. I forget the name. Trimbakeshwar, I think it's called. Yeah, I've been to Trimbakeshwar. Just whatever. Yeah. Ah, you know what? I've been to Arunachalam. You know?
Yes, there are important memories for you. And you have been inspired.
Ramana Maharishi. I did so, Giripradaksham.
You did Giripradaksham. Very good. And it's about 14 kilometers. You can always do it.
But
so now, I want to interest you in the context here that when Durga Parameswari is always Jaya Bhushita and she was able to war with such a huge army of Rakshasas and without any kind of ayasa, and it is everything small. Because, you know, Leela is a special word. It is just reverse that word is Lali. Lali and Leela is changing. That is, you are not at all serious about it. And you are just enjoying that. So Ammavaru was enjoying the war with them. And as she was working in the war, putting down the Arakshasas, you know, there are, and war also is a part of entertainment. The Yajna, Yudha, and the Homa, and some celebrations, all are entertaining. So we know that Kruti, not for the participants, but for the onlookers and viewers. So, when Durga Parameswari or Mahalakshmi was fighting with them, then all were there in the sky to witness the war, how it was going. In fact, in the Rishatanda also, there were so many people witnessing Rama and Ravana fight. The entire Yudham was being witnessed and enjoyed, if you like. It's something like you watching the cricket match. You can call it, the fellow getting out and all that. It is visible, very small, but it's a big war. And so in that war, as she was showing the skill and progress, Surarshithihi Suryamana. Suras and Rishis, both the gods and the sages of all different order and achievements and merits and distinctions, they're all watching Amma fighting the war. Now, if we repeat, Mumocha Suradehesu. 51.
Mumocha Suradeheshu. Mumocha Suradeheshu. Shastranyastrani Sheshwari.
So Pikruddho Dhuta Sato.
Devya Vahana Kesari.
Chachara Sura Sanyeshu.
सचारासुरसंज्ञेषु वने श्रीवहुताशनः वने श्रीवशुताहुताशनः निश्वासानुमुचेयांश्च निश्वासानुमुचेयांश्च युध्यमानारणे अम्बिका युध्यमानारणे अम्बिका त एव सद्य सम्भूता गणाः त एव सद्य सम्भूता गणाः शतसहस्रशः शतसहस्रशः
युधस्ते परशुभिः
युयुधस्ते परशुभिर्भिः युयुधस्ते
परशुभिर्भिः
निन्दिपालासि पट्ठिषैः निन्दिपालासि पट्ठिषैः
So in 51 sloka you get the information that Durga Parameswari has employed a number of arrows and missiles upon the sharira of the asuras asura deheshu And she who is this Mahalakshmi? She is Ishwari. Ishwari Sarvabhutanam. Ishwari So she is Ishwari, all powerful, all commanding. That is the qualification and distinction of Mahalakshmi. Then she was so much actively participating. Then the lion, the Vahanam, It is also sensitive and it is also a warrior. So, as a sensitive participant, it has dhrutasataha krutthaha devyaha vahana kesari. The vahana kesari, that is kesari is the lion. So, and vahanam is a vehicle or upon which devi came to fight with the Rakshasas. And you remember that was the gift given by her father, Himavan. Then all gods have been given number of gifts and empowering her. So Tande, the father, is like giving her a Vahanam. So that she is mobile. So he made Parvati and Durga mobile by doing that. And Just like Sandhya showed her picture, two white dogs, very obedient, and two parrots, very obedient, accepting the male's crown, Namakarnam done to them. So, here also, the Vahanam of Durgamma in the battle was not scared, it also became very angry, and Dhrutasataha, whatever zulu or whatever head, The hair that has got over the neck, he tried to shake very severely. That is the lion's nature. That when it becomes angry, and then its hair at the neck, which of as it is, and that was completely shaken terribly. And then she, when the lion moved in the battleground, in the among the Rakshasas, Just like the fire in the forest, Hutasanaha Vaneshu, that means the conflagration or the wild fire in the forest. A wild fire in the forest nobody can control. Probably you must have seen the documentary talking about this wild fire in the forest. So, it is, and moreover, the wild fire is happening in the bamboo groves. Actually, how does fire generate? Alavasthande, Sanjagaru, Chakkara? Forest lopala, fire la putti ante, బ్యాంబూ ట్రీస్ ఒకటి కొట్టే స్క్రాచ్ అవుతుంది. సో కీచకై పూర్యమానా. సో ది బ్యాంబూ ట్రీస్ సో వెరీ క్లోజ్ త్రూ అండ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది విండ్ దే ట్రై టు స్క్రాచ్ అండ్ బికాస్ ఇన్ ద ట్రీస్ ఇన్ ద వుడ్ అగ్ని ఇస్ హ్యావింగ్ దిస్ డ్వెల్లింగ్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద డ్వెల్లింగ్ ప్లేస్ ఆఫ్ అగ్ని వుడ్. That's why in America everybody is afraid of fire. Small smoke makes people very much worried. I mean, wherever wooden places are there is a kind of safety should take place. So Deviya Vahana Kesari and Vaneshiva Hutasana. So the Vahana Kesari has been likened to the Agni, the fire. And that too not ordinary fire. Wild fire. Jwala mala parivrutaha agnihi. And then what is her? Ambika rane vidyamana vishwasan mumuche. Then she went on showing out her feelings in the war as she was fighting. Then sadhyaha sana satasaha sambhuta. They all fought with the Rakshasas, Pattisaihi, Indripalaihi, Parasurai. So with that kind of set of weapons, they all fight with that. Then Devi, what is she doing? Now 54, please repeat. Nasayanto Asuraganan Devi.
नाशयन्तो असुर गणान् देवी नाशयन्तो असुर गणान् देवी
शक्ति उपब्रह्मिताः
शक्त्युपम् ब्रहिताः शक्त्युपम् ब्रहिताः
अवादयन्तपटहान्
अवादयन्तपटहान् अवादयन्तपटहान्
गणाः शङ्खांस्तथा परे
गणाः शङ्खास्तथा परे गणाः शङ्खास्तथा परे
खड्गाभिनो मृदङ्गाश्च तथैवान्ये
मृदङ्गाश्च तथैवान्ये मृदङ्गाश्च तथैवान्ये
तस्मिन् युद्धमहोत्सवे
तस्मिन् युद्धो महोत्सवे तस्मिन् युद्धो महोत्सवे
ततो देवी त्रिशूलेन गदया च
ततो देवी त्रिशूलेन गदया शक्तिवृष्टिभिः ततो देवी त्रिशूलेन गदया शक्तिवृष्टिभिः
खड्गादिभिश्च शतशो निजघान
खड्गादिभिश्च शतशो निजघाना खड्गादिभिश्च शतशो निजघाना
महासुरान्
महासुरान् महासुरान्
पातयामास चैवान्यान्
पातयामाश्चैवान्यान् पातयामाश्चैवान्यान्
महास्वर विमोहितान्
महास्वर विमोहितान् आई हैव घंटास्वन विमोहितान्
या घंटास्वन विमोहितान्
घंटास्वन विमोहितान् घंटास्वन मिहो विमोहितान्.
सो नाउ व्हेन राक्षसा व्हेन द फाइट इटसेल्फ यू नो देयर आर वॉर इंप्लीमेंट्स वॉर म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स in order to encourage the warriors. Music is always useful in any aspect. So soft music is there, wild music is there, and that music will bring up enthusiasm and spirit and all that. So what is doing that? Devi is killing all the Asuraganas with her shaktis. And that has also become exalted. Shakti upabrahmitaha. Upabrahmana is to grow bigger, huge. and exciting or expressively high. When she was trying to destroy all the Asuraganas, the other Asuras, what they did, in order to encourage other soldiers fighting in the war, what was the way that they can encourage other soldiers? So, what the avadayanta patahan shankham aparegana. So, those ganas were those groups of rakshasas who are fighting. One group try to beat and play very many instruments, pataha, trumpets, and shankha, the conches, because they are all war implements. So that patanada, the nagare, so they keep on, they are all high sound producing, and when the instruments are played, people get inspired not to care their body, not to care, but they care only to kill the enemy. That will be their motto. Because in a war, what is the motto? Yashova Mrityurva. Either you should get a kirti or you should die. That must be the spirit of fight. So here, all these other ganas, they went on playing the patahas, shankhas, and likewise mrudanga. Even mrudanga also is a war instrument. Mrudangascha anye yuddha mahotsave. You know, yuddha is a utsava. What do you mean by utsava? Utsava ante is actually a sacrificial word. Sava means pressing the soma. Utsava means collecting the soma rasa in soma sacrifice in order to offer.
Where is the utsava word? Utsava, where is that word?
You just now read it in 55th stanza, first line.
Mrudangascha tathai vanya vanye tasmin yuddha. Utsava, mahotsave is utsava.
So,
maha utsava.
Yes.
Oh, beautiful.
So, celebration. You see, for warriors, yuddha is a celebration.
So, utsava is collection of soma.
Yeah, when you talk about utsava, yeah, to press soma leaves and prepare soma juice. And it is a utsava, is soma sacrifice. Soma yaga is supposed to be a wonderful yaga, there which involves so many things, and there are number of formulas to be employed when soma sacrifice. So,
but usually when we say utsava, it means of like festival.
Yeah, it's a celebration.
Celebration.
So for all heroic people who receive training all through the time, unless they get the yuddham, there is a celebration for that, for them to show their talent. You know, all lovers wait for an occasion to show off their tastes and skills and all that, is it not? And that's what we call utsava. Whenever you perform something like that, for example, janmadinotsava, vivaha utsava, so utsava is a special activity where you collect people, where you collect necessary sambharas, where you invite so many people with whom you share all that. So all that, and people, when you are sharing your things with others, you are happy only. You are not distressed. Oh, I am giving tambula, I am giving coconut, I am giving rose, I am giving, do you think like that? No. When you are having some good function, you invite your friends. When they come, you feed them, give them all gifts and all that. So what is it due to? It's all utsava. So, but the word utsava comes from the Soma Yaga in Ayurveda, and somehow that utsava has become a habit for all human beings. That's why Kalidasa, in Meghasandhi, अभिज्ञान शाकुंतलम आलदर्दामस विशेष उत्सव प्रिया खलु मनुष्या इफ यू ग्रेजुएट सेलेब्रेट ग्रेजुएशन इफ यू मे परफॉर्म समथिंग गुड सेलेब्रेट इट बर्थडे सेलेब्रेट ऑल सेलेब्रेशन इज कॉल्ड उत्सव देयर यू हैव मोर एंड मोर उत्साह enthusiasm. In your enthusiasm, you will forget yourself. When so many friends come, you forget all your things and you try to treat them very well and look after them very well. So, for all heroic people, Yuddha, so for them, war is a utsava. Not simple utsava, it's a great celebration, mahotsava. See, actually, the soldiers are waiting for the war. When war comes, that is the time when they can exhibit their skill, training, and everything they can. They have opportunity. That's why it's called Yuddha Utsava, Yuddha Utsava. And normal fights are called Yuddha Utsavas, competitions. But a war like so many Rakshasas coming and attack Durga Parameswari and all that is a utsava. And likewise, when Rama is fighting with Ravana and all asuras, and Sugriva and all, we also are cooperating and all that, so it's also a big utsava, the yuddha between Rama and Ravana. Whenever it is a utsava, a celebration, many people watch. So that watching the utsava itself is a big job. That's why more among entertainments, Yajna is a Utsava and Yuddha is a Utsava. Therefore, if two people are fighting, 100 people keep on watching, isn't it? So, it's a kind of celebration, fighting. If two cocks are fighting, cock fight. Then moreover, when the cock are getting hurt on Makara Sankranti days in Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu and all that, they will have cockfights. So that's a utsava. Like that, when this Mahotsava is going on, what is that? Devi Trishulena Gadaya Shakti Vrishtivihi Kaggadihi Sataha Satasaha Mahasuran Jizaghana. So Amma, she killed the chieftains. Mahasuras are the commanders in chief, number of them. The chieftains among Rakshasas, all of them have been put down, killed by her sword and a Shakti of weapons and so many other things. She was able on Gada, the base, and with all those instruments, she tried to reduce the enemy army. So Asura Sainya is becoming dwindled down because of the prowess of Devi Durga. So here is a pure war description. What happens when war takes place? So this is one instance. And now if we repeat Asuran, I hope you understood all the words in the slokam. Durga, all are musical instruments, war implements. And they are just played during the war to encourage the players, to encourage the soldiers. Because the soldiers become dull when they find so much of atmosphere there like that. So they are to be screwed up of their courage. And therefore, as some people are playing upon the mridanga and all that, Devi also got inspired at those sounds. The war sounds, the war implements. Then Nijaghana Mahasuran. Then not only that, Patayama Sacha Evanyan Ganta Swanavimohitan. So she's got Chandra Ganta Devi, you must have heard name, did it not? Sandhya Vinaran, you know, Lachusaran. During the Dasara, Navaratris, I think 7th, 6th or 8th day, on third day sometimes, Chandra Ganta Devi Alankara is done for Devi.
Mm.
घंटा ఒకటి ఉంటుంది కొంచెం సీరియస్ వారు కోపంగా ఉంటారంట
అంటే మా చంద్ర ఘంట అంటే వార్ గాడెస్ లైక్ లైక్ దట్ ఐ నాట్ గెటింగ్ గెటింగ్ ద నేమ్ సో దేర్ ఆర్ సెట్ శక్తిస్ హు ఆర్ వెరీ వెల్ ట్రైన్డ్ ఇన్ ది వార్ అండ్ దే విల్ బి ఏబుల్ టు ఫైట్ వార్ వెల్ therefore and they made produce such a sound by the bell sound in war what is that you hear in war only ha ha karas and in war you will see blood flow you will see various musical instruments and high rated sounds of instruments so gola gola ga untundandi యుద్ధము అంటే దెర్ ఇస్ నో పీస్ అట్ ఆల్ ఇన్ ది వార్ ఎవరీబడి విత్ ఆల్ ఎంథూజియాజం ఫైట్ ద రేస్
వాట్ ఇస్ ద బెల్ సిగ్నిఫికెంట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద బెల్ సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ అంకుల్ ఇస్ ఇట్
సౌండ్ బెల్ ఇస్ సౌండ్
సౌండ్ యా బట్ ఇస్ ఇట్ లైక్
సౌండ్ యా యూ జస్ట్ పుట్ ఎ క్వశ్చన్ వీక్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఫర్ యూ పుట్ ఎ క్వశ్చన్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఆన్సరింగ్ గుడ్
నో ఐ థింక్ బెల్ సౌండ్ ఇస్ బికాజ్ ఇస్ ఇట్ బికాజ్ దట్ successful when you become successful you ring the bell is it like that
not necessary
okay
bell is to draw attention your dog barks that means you take note of the dog's presence otherwise so bell agamartha actually in religious way the bell sound makes the gods to enter your prayer hall and make the rakshasas to get away from the prayer hall because they don't like you doing puja I don't want to witness the puja they go away gamanartham tu rakshasam so for to make the rakshasas go away you make a bell sound it's symbolic and you make a bell in school you know all people are talking in the compound in under the tree they ring the bell in school and colleges some colleges So in America there is no bell, of course, your watch only. But you must have seen in India, bell is important. So when bell makes the teacher go away, you impetus for the new teacher to come and start the class, isn't it? And they wait for the bell. So bell has got different significations and purposes. But war bell is different. Our war bell sounds are different. The sounds are so terrifying. You can't stand the war bells. Therefore, they are called ghanta swana. Some people faint when such high-sounded bells are being given or produced, and they die. Some people also die when the twang of the bow, big twang of the bow, that's called dhanushtankara. When they make the dhanushtankara, people are afraid, they die. So sensitivity is also important, but those who are not able to stand the sound intensity or velocity, they will die. So, Ammavaru, em chestunte, kontha mandini tana khadgam cheta, she tried to put them down, and some people were put down, because of the high sounds of the bells that are there employed by her sainyam. Yes. Now 57, please repeat. Asuran bhuvipasena.
Asuran bhuvipasena. Asuran bhuvipasena.
Bhadva chalyana karsayatu.
Bhadvan.
चान्यान
कर्षयत् बद्वान चान्यान कर्षयत्
केचित् विधा कृतास्तीकैः
केचित् विधा द्विधा कृतास्तैः केचित् विधा कृतास्तैः तैः
खड्गपातैस्तथा परे
खड्गपातैश्चथा परे खड्गपातैश्चथा परे
सो इन पुराणास एंड काव्यास Yugna Varnana is also one of the Varnanas. So in this Markandeya Purana, Markandeya Maharshi visualizes how Durga Parameswari fought with the Rakshasas. And even that war scene also is being beautifully described, and that is the power of the Rishi who is able to visualize. So Rishis are all called as the Kranta Darshis. What is not visible to their eye, that becomes visible to their imagination. So Kavihi Kranta Darshihi Antaru. Ante, who is a poet? A poet is able to see things, perceive things which ordinarily ordinary people cannot perceive. So their vision is very far off, and they are able to depict all of them. Therefore, there is that kind kechit with under. So some people are being bhuvi pasena badva asuran akarshayatu. So she employed her pasha. Pasha is the rope. Tadu. So tadu lo mechanical ga magical ga untundi. So she employed the pasha or shaktis and tied them all together, badva, and those people who are running away from the battleground or whatever condition, so to make them come closer to her, she employed the pasha, the ropes over the asuras and brought them closer to them, akarshayatu. And some people, how was the battle? The battle was having different situations, and it will be having asakhida and jugupsa. Jugupsa means you can't tolerate a battleground, because there are asuras who have been cut in the body. Vidha krutaha, they are made into two parts with their swords, and also because of the sword strikings, the other people also lost their life. And again, how was the war ground? That ground has been, why war has been described by her, by Markandeya, who is a great Shakti Upasaka. If at all, when Durga Parameswari and Rakshasas are fighting, ordinary people cannot see that. But only a specialized mob, Rishis and Devas, they would only be able to visualize. And next to 58 verse, please repeat. Vipo Chitaripa, yes.
Uncle, okay, second. Idi, can I read this one again, Uncle? Kechit Tridakrutaha Tikshanaihi Katka
Patahi Tatha Apare.
Apare.
Tishna Katka Pata is the Tishna means the sharp. Sharp strikings of the kinds of swords, their body became split into two divisions. Vidha krutaha, how they are made half, I mean their body is cut anyway, something like the postmortem surgeons. If body is living, the surgery is different. If body is dead, the postmortem system is different. Therefore, the surgeon will give instruction to the students. You should first consider the body is living or dead. Then, if the body is living, his instruction is different. If the body is dead, his instruction is different. It's all for medical students. I don't know, but I was told by my friends how they do the operative systems like that. In the lecture, chala bhavan Rita Garu, see, the lecture yesterday I sent it to you, and you must listen about the Indian wisdom contribution for the food, health and glow. That lady, mute, you are mute.
See, what happened was I had it in my calendar, but somehow I didn't see the notice for the meeting yesterday. I've missed it. I'm really sad about that on Sunday.
So many doctors have participated. Nananda, his father, his mother, Smita, and some other doctors.
So but yesterday's topic was that food engineer?
Yeah, food engineer, yes.
Right.
There was also, she also talked about fasting. I remember Rita very much. Because
I know, I forgot. I don't know what happened to me.
Yeah, in fact, that was really put in the, Seshachalaya put in our website also. You must have seen, reminder.
No, I don't go to the website. I usually look on the WhatsApp.
WhatsApp only, I could not remember. In WhatsApp only, I could notice.
Yes.
Anyway.
I should have been there. Oh my God.
So anyway, you have watched the YouTube.
I'll do that.
Then you can make comments. Still, she's available for questions.
Yeah.
So she is a Tamilian, but born and brought up in America only, completely American. So, but has Indian connections, and therefore she was talking about the banana leaf eating, food upon banana leaf. That's the best luxurious way, not any other metal plate in which we start our eating. Anyway, this is different. So I am just trying to say that Tishna Khadgapata. Khadgapata is the striking by the sword. And that too, not with great speed. So with great force. With that great force, with a sword, what would happen? The body becomes cut. Therefore, it was a dvidha krutaha. They lost one part of their body, they come half of it and all that. So in war, what would be there? In a big good war, there will be only all this kind of sides. That's why a war ground is highly jugupsa puritam bhavati. That's jugupsa rasa comes up. That among nine rasas, the jugupsa rasa happens. You can't like the war ground after battle or during the battle, but you must have a special mind. So then again, now we repeat 58. I hope Sandhya got the meaning. So it's all because of the sword. Because those days, the sword, dhanus, arrow, and other implements were important. In fact, Vishnu has got 24 implements. Tatha angapani rakshobhyah sarva praharana yudhah om namaiti. I think Friday we should come for Vishnu Sahasranam. You are missing interesting discussion on that for some time. Too many are there. I know you should drop down other things and try to listen. Vishnu, Lalita, they are good friends. So I will be translating Vishnu Sahasranam to Lalita and Lalita to Vishnu. Because both are two energies working to guard the land and people. So, please repeat.
He's not blessing me there, Uncle. He's not blessing me yet to come there.
Yeah, I'm urging you to not to miss. Because once you leave for India, you'll be missing all these things. I cannot be so regular as much as I am. But here, Vishnu Sahasranam going on. And there you see.
Prabhakar Garu, see in this global world, there's no need for you to go back to India. You can do everything from here itself.
But I'm not that expert, but we have to go.
No, you must please consider this point, because if you go to India, then we will, what about us?
But I don't know. It was because there are also so many, if you come on Budhavar, Tuesday and Wednesday lectures, more than 18-20 people will log in. So I covered that Trisuparna mantra. Yes, for Rita and Sandhya, this Trisuparna mantras are very important. And I try to explain the significance of Rishabhandha mantras from Mahanara, because while taking food for purification of the food, one have the Brahmins will recite the three, and Rishabhandha is Agni himself, Jirna Agni, I mean the Sudha Agni and Jirna Agni, all that will be helped by reciting all that. This is written, now it has come out in YouTube. So you can listen to that YouTube, 4 or 5 sessions are there. I think today I completed the last bit of that, and Trisuparnas. So, anyway, so I am always with you, and you are always with us. That's why I urge you, whenever possible, even for 10 minutes, you appear and disappear, I don't matter. Vishnu doesn't matter, because Vishnu also does the same thing. When you call him for Bhaga, Yajna Bhaga, he will come, take and get out. But Ganapati is the only one person who will stay and still from beginning to the ending. That's why we invite Ganapati. When Ganapati comes, all gods will think that, oh, the Yajna has started. Now, please repeat. Vipothitaha nipatena.
Vipothita nipatena. Vipothita nipatena.
Gadaya bhuvise rate.
Gadaya bhuvise rate. Gadaya bhuvise rate.
Ve muscha kechit rudhiram.
Ve muscha kechit
rudhiram.
Ve muscha kechit rudhiram.
Musalena brusham hata.
Musalena brusham hata. Musalena brusham hataha.
Kechinna vipatita bhumau.
Kechinni patita bhumau. Kechinni patita bhumau.
Bhinnaha shulena vakshasi.
Aha shulena vakshasi. Bhinnana shulena vakshasi.
So, Nirantaraha sharaugheena.
Nirantaraha sharaugheena. Nirantaraha sharaugheena.
Ritaha kechidrana jire.
Ritaha kechidrana jire. Ritaha kechidrana jire.
How did Amma Durga Parameswari fight in the war? You ask always the players, cricket players, soccer, hockey, soccer players, you know, people spend, lakhs of people gather to watch their playing. But here, how Durga Parameswari is fighting the war, especially the top 2 demons, Mahishasura and his large army. And what she was, her army and she was hitting some Rakshasas with Gada, with a mace, and with that stroke, many people have been reduced to land, killed. They always, one by one, they are falling down on the ground, dead. Bhuvi means upon the earth, Serate means dying. Sera is to rest or to end up there, or death. That's why, Bhuvi Serate, they are all coming down. When they are strong fighting, they stand perpendicular to the ground and fight. When they are hurt and hit and pounded, they fall down dead on the ground. And again, another set of people, they muschakejat rudhiram musalena brusham hataha. Musala is another war, another weapon. Then they want another rokali. So rokalato kutarma. When they are hit with that musalam or rokali, very strong. The war rokali is different from your pachari rokali. The pachari rokali is the chinnavi, castor, the BM dampadam. But in war, it will be very heavy. If it hits, the people can't live. So musala ayuda, with that, when people are hurt or hit, they were vomiting blood. Rudhiram Vemuhu is the word. Rudhiram, blood. Vemuhu vomited. Some people, being hurt by that, they vomited blood. And 59th sloka, some more rakshasas, they were sulena vachasi vinna bhumau nipatitaha. So, with the sula ayudha, their body has been split into parts. When their body is split into parts with a trident or trisulam, they again fall down on the ground dead. So, bhumi is the one resort for all people, for good or bad or different. And another, you know, I have to tell you a story. All children, all living upon the earth are taken as children of Bhumata, is it not? So we are all Prithvi Putraha, Prithvi Mataha, Javuhu Pita. Yakasam is the father and Bhumi is the mother. So Parvati gave a shapa to Bhudevi. Tirusamma is Kathamiku, do you know this story? In Bhagavatam, see, when there was some kind of emergency, Bhumata and all gods went to meet Shiva, report or submit prayer that he should come and then solve the problem. At that time, Parvati had earned a romantic time with Shiva. It is a great difficulty and Shiva is with him. And at that hour, these people go and knock the door. And disturb their hard-earned private life. And Shiva is not disturbed, but Parvati got irritated too much. Then she cursed Bhudevi and gods. She cursed Bhudevi two ways. One, that whoever wants you to possess, he must fight a war and lose his blood or body. So, you as a mother have got to bear your own children's blood upon you. That's one curse for Bhudevi. There is no peace at all for Bhudevi, because whoever wants land, expand the state, they have to fight and then they lose their body. So that's one thing given for Bhudevi, a curse for gods. Another curse was that they never get children through their respective dharma patnis. They are outsourced to get the children, but they never have like human beings. So like that, in Puranas we get it. So, sulena vachasi bhubhinna bhumau nipatitaha kechit. And on some other people, second line of 59th, nirantaraha sarauhena krutaha kechitu ranajire. So, ranajire. See, ranajire means in the war, which is an occasion for enjoyment. Ranam ante enjoyment. Aranam ante no enjoyment. So, aranya means you cannot enjoy in forest. Indukumma?
There's nothing to enjoy there.
Bhayam?
Fear.
Wild animals are there and crawling animals are there. So much a problem in the forest. You cannot be at peace. Therefore, it is called as a aranya. Naranam yatra aranyam. No enjoyment. But yuddhamu, functions, celebrations, they are all taken as joyous moments. So, ranam means enjoyment. Like that, here, ranajire in the yuddharangam, because of the constant flow of the arrows upon the rakshasas, they were not able to withstand the arrow flow upon them, and they are all tortured and they are all falling down from there. Well, okay, 15 minutes after what is the number? In the class, no, another phone. Class, no, ma'am. ఇంకొక 5-10 నిమిషాలు మళ్ళీ చేస్తాను. సో యు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది వర్డ్ రణాజిరే. అజిర రణం, దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ఎ వెరీ ఘాస్ట్లీ వార్, ఇన్ ఎ వెరీ పవర్ఫుల్ వార్, దెర్ వాజ్ ఎ కంటిన్యూస్ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ యారోస్ అండ్ దట్స్ వై దే కాల్ బాణవర్షం దినరణం. సో బాణవర్షము అంటే బాణాలు రెయిన్ లా కాన్స్టెంట్ గా పడిపోతుంటే హౌ కెన్ పీపుల్ ఎస్కేప్. అండ్ సిమిలర్లీ సునామీ వేవ్స్ ఆల్సో ఇస్ అ ప్రాబ్లం. ది వేవ్స్ అట్ సునామీ విల్ బి ఆఫ్ ది హైట్ ఆఫ్ 20, 25, 30 feet హై అండ్ దే ఆర్ సో షార్ప్ దట్ దే విల్ కట్ ఆఫ్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ క్లోజ్ బై. ఐ హ్యాపెన్ టు గో టు మచిలీపట్నం బందర్ సీ బీచ్ ఆఫ్టర్ జస్ట్ ఆఫ్ సమ్ సునామీ, సా హౌ దట్ వేవ్స్ హవ్ కట్ ఆఫ్ ద బిల్డింగ్స్ క్లోజ్ బై. And all that was really a great knowledge and experience for me to see the after effect of the tsunami or the wave power, because they are all very sharp, they can cut down. So similarly, the arrows, bana vrishti.
Prabhakar garu, is it okay if I leave now?
Yeah, I'm stopping it here.
Okay.
It is time now. So we have done that. I mean, the war is going on. Let them keep doing war. We'll go and have some different time. Okay? But Durga Parameswara is the war, trying to war that.
Kechit ante entanku?
Few. Kontamandi.
Oh, few. Kechit, okay.
Kontamandi itta, kontamandi aritika, kontamandi they were vomiting the blood, some people getting their body cut into. So, then Lopala, you cannot imagine, that's all accident. So you can't predict an accident and the description of the accident, is it not? That's that. So we stop here. Om Tat Sat.
Om Tat Sat.
Om Sri Krishna Arpanamastu.
Om Sri Krishna Arpanamastu. Om Sri Krishna
Matru Charana Arvinda Arpanamastu.
Om Sri Matru Charana Arvinda Arpanamastu.
మాతృచరణ అరవింద అర్పణ వస్తు. ఓం
దక్షండి. రాజలక్ష్మి అండి, గురూజీ
ఎలా ఉన్నారమ్మా? మీ అమ్మాయి డెలివరీ అయ్యింది.